Survival is impossible without water. Today I sit down with my good friend Josh. He's the co-founder of Puri Bag, a company that specializes in the development of innovative mobile water treatment solutions. You might have seen the Puri Bag products go viral on YouTube. Whether you're into preparedness or just love to get out in nature, I think you'll enjoy this conversation. Josh, it's good to have you with us here today. How you doing, man?
Good, Gordon. It's always a pleasure. I haven't seen you in person in months, so it's good to see your face, man. I've missed you.
Same, absolutely. So we're here today to talk about all things water and water purification, sterilization, filtering. What is the difference between those terms, and how does your product, you know, interface with that? That's what we're going to talk about. And I also want to get into the new adventure line that you guys have come out with. But take me back to the beginning. Like, where did this water filter that's gone viral, where did this whole idea come from?
Wow, it's hard-hitting questions for a Thursday morning, my friend. okay, so the long story in the shortest form possible. My brother and I, Simon, co-founder, he's Melbourne-based while I'm, you know, putting on my Texan hat here. We came up with a concept for a new wine closure. We grew up in a wine region, went down the path of that, and had some questions around like, hey, can the same principle be applied to water, water purification in like a emergency preparedness context? Our first product was really, you know, this guy here, really born of the idea that what if we could have something that's lightweight, easy to use, almost foolproof in many ways, that could be distributed immediately after a disaster event. So we were thinking, you know, we'd love to, in a perfect state, imagine this being in like a Red Cross disaster preparedness shelter or any municipalities that are wanting to stockpile goods for, you know, or in readiness for a disaster event, whether it be a flood, a cyclone or something like that, and actually give people a mechanism to create safe drinking water rather than being reliant on, you know, the Red Cross distribution center or, you know, a global empowerment mission or someone like that. So trying to look at many different levels on how and where we can help people and provide, you know, a pretty cost-effective solution to provide access to water immediately after an event. And that led to this entire journey that has sort of brought us to the now and you know, a significant number of views in between time, thanks to the folks at Battlebox and some of their videos in the last couple of years. So yeah, it's been an interesting one, man. I got to say, if you'd asked me a few years ago if I thought this is where I would be, I probably would have said no.
I've heard it said that entrepreneurship is a series of near-death experiences. Does that feel right?
Yeah, and then then a few more highs and lows to go with it as well. It's really important to have great people around you, and you know, some belief in what you're trying to do, and also a little bit of flexibility and agility. I think that you, if you can be open to different ideas and pivoting a little bit and seeing new market opportunity and potential, then you know that's kind of how you can then seize upon different opportunities as well.
You've got this core product that is just wild. Like, the science behind it is just so cool. Like, it's very visual. You fill this bag, this Puri bag, up with dirty water, and you put the sachet of chemical in it or whatever, and then, you know, you shake it about, and then you hang it up, and it just, over time, it just settles all to the bottom, all the junk and impurities. What is that process called? It's wild.
Flocculation is where it binds together all of the particulate matter and all the bad stuff, and it brings it into clumps that you see as it comes down, and then it sort of drops to the bottom. So it's pretty wild. I still find myself getting sort of absorbed and like lost as I'm just following like different clumps that like fall in the water and then join onto the next one. It's like trying to follow a drop on a water fountain. As you watch it hit the top and then come down. But flocculation is where it sort of all binds together. And then it's pulled down to the bottom. And so we tried to think, how do we make, you know, a solution that's different to something called the Day One Response Bag, which came out a number of years ago, which didn't allow for people to, you know, evacuate the contaminants and get rid of some of the bad stuff. It was an inverse where the particulate matter sat at the bottom. again, used the same Procter and Gamble treatment compound, and allowed people to access safe drinking water, which is the goal at the end of the day. We just thought we could do it a little bit differently. And so, then we tried to work in how do we design something that, allows for this treatment compound to work. But then where can we add something different in there? And so that's where we came up with sort of the twist and lock mechanism, and then the evacuation of the stuff.
It's fun to use. It's absolutely critical for like preparedness situations. I feel like that's like a product that is just awesome for somebody that's trying to do a bit of like preparing for disasters, or even like if you've been through a disaster, to have someone give you one of those things is just incredible.
Yeah, I appreciate it. And I hope you've enjoyed using yours.
You guys have this product, which we're going to talk about too, and it has the microfilter integrated into it. So this is like really standard kind of kit for people who do a lot of backpacking and camping and stuff like that. They're used to seeing this kind of a product, but they're not necessarily used to seeing it in the context of a water bladder where you can fill it. You can fill this up with dirty water right from a stream or something like that, and then filter it later. This doesn't slow you down. You can just kind of fill it up and get going. And so where did the genesis of this come from? Like, this is an adventure product. How did you guys get into that space?
Well, first of all, Gordon, I feel like we need to bring you on as a hype man, because everything you're saying is just getting me super pumped about these products. Looking at sort of the emergency and disaster preparedness side of things, obviously there's a pretty significant marketplace here in the US, but I think if the last 5 years have taught us anything, it's that people are realizing the importance of being outside and fresh air and being around nature, and what that can do for us, mentally and psychologically and emotionally and everything else. So as we started thinking about, how and where can we iterate and ideate and come up with some different products, form and function have always been super important to us in terms of, we want things to be lightweight, we want them to be pretty easy to use, and we want to give you some optionality and some choice. So when it came to the adventure pack, one of the biggest things for us was what is impractical to carry, and it's difficult, so if you're hiking and you're wanting to go to a challenging sort of terrain, the concept of carrying, 3 or 4 gallons with you isn't really that practical. And depending on where you are, depending on time of year, you might not have the option to boil water. So we thought, what if we enter this space, which there's a lot of amazing quality products out there, a lot of different brands. So what if our hook is that we give you functionality and choice? So for us, it was like, okay, if there's the standard bladder, that comes with the hose, there's a number of companies that are offering those, but what if we can provide a second hose that has a filter in line, and you simply have the choice. So, the main thing with the adventure bladder and the adventure pack is that you never need to carry more than 2 liters of water at a time. So you can continue on. And as I was explaining to some folks in Phoenix, last month, I was like, listen, you could literally leave the car, you could be gone for a couple of days, and you never need to carry more than, essentially half a gallon of water with you, as long as you can find a different source for water. And so, that I think gives people a lot more freedom in what they're trying to do, and it gives people a lot more choice in terms of the terrain they tackle, or the adventure that they go on. And at the end of the day, we want people to enjoy spending time outside and be safe doing it, and really be able to like embrace what we can do, and push the limits of where we can go.
What's cool about this is that it's a pack that holds the bladder, but you also have another little like pouch on the outside for your car keys or for your whatever you're gonna put in there, your sunscreen. And so this is great for like trail runners, people that are just going out for a hike. And what's cool about it is that you've got the hose, to drink out of, but this is also can be used as a gravity system, right? So you can string this up in a tree, and then if you have the filter lower than the bladder, it'll drain out into a container. Is that right?
Oh, absolutely. So you could use it in the same way that you would be using a squeeze. You got the bladder, it's sealed, and you're pushing the water through, and then it can just come out, and then you could boil it and sort of add it to some of those ReadyWise or peak refuel meals, or any of the great brands that are out there. So we've got a family member who uses it like cycling and mountain biking all the time. So they go out in the hills around Laguna, and just have that guy on, and then they can, they just find a stream or something, and they're able to just fill it up and then keep going, as opposed to, trying to be burdened with a whole bunch of water. And so, yeah, a brother-in-law likes to go gold foraging in Australia as well with a metal detector. So he has it so that he can, put it on, get out there, get rich, and hopefully he returns that favor to us sometime. But fundamentally, I think another thing that we're trying to do here is give people peace of mind, so that, if they know that they're drinking it through a filter, the water may look clean, but it might not be clean. And I've seen some of the rivers that you were fishing in recently doing the fly fishing thing, like that all looks clean, but there's certainly stuff that's in there. And so just having that little extra bit of peace of mind and comfort, so that you aren't struck down by, some issues with your stomach or whatever it might be, because you drank water that looked clean and you didn't have an opportunity to boil it.
For sure. So this will filter out like Giardia,
Yeah, so that's a membrane filter. It'll take care of a lot of stuff. It's very similar to some of the other ones that are out there. And we thought, okay, how do we then make something unique in terms of incorporating the filter into our offering? And it comes with a plastic syringe, so you can back flush it and ensure that it's clean. And you'll get a few hundred gallons out of that over its life. So it's they do clog. If you were trying to take sort of the dirty water, like you've seen in the battle box Puribag video, some of that stuff, like you won't get as much life out of it as you might if you're tackling a cleaner stream and you just want to ensure that you're taking care of some of the bad stuff. But there's certainly some form and function to it, and we, want to put it in at a price point that's pretty attainable for people as well.
I love the innovation of it and what you guys are doing with just the preparedness side, but also the adventure side. Do you have any ideas? Do I have to sign an NDA? Are you gonna you have anything coming down the pipe?
But no, certainly a couple of things coming up the pike. Again, definitely wanting to, create sort of an ecosystem of Puribag products that can be suitable and applicable for different situations. And really hope that people will then, look to Puribag for solutions that, can enhance their life, whether it be, regular city life, whether it be the preparedness and peace of mind that comes from, your go bag or otherwise, or whether it just be getting out and adventuring and, enjoying the warm weather or the cold weather, or, wherever you want to head, when you're off into the great outdoors.
It's awesome. You are connecting people with water in the same way that a lot of us talk about being connected with our food, knowing where our food comes from. But like having water safety in all the situations of your life is so important. Water is the only human need that can't be postponed.
Yeah, you're not wrong. You're not wrong. It was interesting when we were together in Savannah last year. I was chatting to someone, and they said, "Look, it's amazing." People like, "Oh yeah, I know how to filter water," and then you're like, "Okay, do it," and they're like, "Actually, I've never done this before. I've just, looked at it, and it seems manageable." So, my advice would be for people to practice these tools and their craft. And, if it's something that you're interested in doing and a skill set that you want to possess, definitely get out there and give it a try, and make sure you're comfortable with it, because you never know when you might find yourself needing it. In the same way that you should be able to change a tire on a car, you never know when you might need to do it. And it's just I feel like it's a practical life skill, man.
It's like when I take people on survival campouts and I teach them how to make primitive fire. It's like this wonderful feeling that they get from, yes, they've made fire in a way they've never done it before, but it's also like giving them confidence on some other level to tackle their life in a different way. And so like learning to do these skills, you may never need it. We hope you never need it, but you have that in your back pocket, you have that knowledge in your mind, and you've practiced it, and it gives you confidence.
Jordan, I love that you said that, and I could see how rewarding it was for you. Even as describing that, when you're probably thinking back on scenarios where you helped someone make primitive fire, like I could see how rewarding that was for you, because you lit up as you were telling that little tidbit. So that's very cool. And we see these survival shows as well, and you watch alone or something like that, and people are saying, "Oh, that's not doesn't look so difficult. I could do that." But I mean, I'm not sure I'd be comfortable getting dropped off in the wilds of Alaska and doing all of it. But yeah, it's a skill, and I think it's something that we should invest a little bit of time in, because the confidence is something that you can take into every aspect of your life, really.
So if the show alone calls me and they say we're doing a team season, I'm inviting you to be on my team. Would you come do alone with me? Alone together?
Alone together. Yeah, I'm down, but I
Yeah.
definitely need some prep time, and I need to learn a few skills from you, and I'll try and bring a few things to the table, and I'm sure I'll bring some wild jokes, and hopefully not too much complaining about the uncomfortable mattress that we have to make on the floor or something.
That's right. Totally. And one of your 10 items is definitely going to be a Puri bag or an adventure bag for sure, because we're going to need clean water.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I think we can do everything with it, and no one is stating the importance of it. Like you said, 3 days, like it's vital to life, and yeah, it's a skill, and it's something that's really important. So we can't look past how important it is to take care of our waterways as a society, and that allows us to get out and enjoy them in a responsible way.
Josh, thank you so much for hanging out as usual. We love hanging out.
Yeah, man, it's a
So,
pastime. I'm
yeah.
down. Anytime, you know that. I look forward to seeing you sometime soon. And
Cool.
I would like to see the adventure pack on the Pantheon Hall of Fame of backpacks you've got back there. I'd like to
Oh,
see
for
that one
sure.
hanging up so the logo can be seen by future viewers.
For sure. I'm going to stick it up there. Awesome.
Love it. And if a shameless plug time, if anyone is interested in any of the Puribag product suite, head to puribagwater.com. I'm
Cool.
hoping you'll put the link below.
Yeah.
And we are on YouTube now, so if you want to subscribe, we just started our page and trying to build a presence there so we can showcase other people taking adventures, using the products, enjoying the great outdoors, and making people aware of what's possible.
Awesome. Thank you so much for your time, Josh.
I appreciate you,
All
Gordon.
right.
Always a pleasure.